Subscribe now and press the bell icon to never miss any tech update from InnoSphere.
Now that your fundamentals are clear about electricity, we can move to Arduino basics. If you have missed my previous videos, you can click here and go through them. Now, if you remember from the first video, Arduino functions similar to human brain. So to understand it better, let's see how the human brain functions. Let's take a simple example of catching a ball. At first, our brain is waiting for signals or data so that it can understand its environment. Like when the ball is coming towards us, our eyes acts as a sensor and sends input to the brain regarding its position and speed. Now our brain starts to process the data and starts calculating the position of the ball. After it does that, brain starts sending output signals to your legs and arms so as to set your position to receive the ball. So that's how every smart system works. There are three parts: inputs, sending signals to the brain, and then brain sending signals to the outputs. For example, let's take the auto brightness feature of a smartphone. The moment you switch it on, the light sensor on top of your mobile gets active and starts sending signals about light levels to the internal chip or brain of the system. Now, based on levels of light, the chip sends signal to the display of your device to increase or decrease the display brightness. Now here, Arduino can be used as a brain for any such function. So basically, it has to take inputs from the sensors, then take decisions and give required outputs outside. So the next question is, what kind of signals are received and transmitted by the Arduino? So to understand that, let's see how human brain does that. So the moment a ball comes flying towards you, the eye starts sending electrical signals to the brain to convey information about the ball. And this communication is done through neurons, which act as electrical wires inside the brain. So the inputs received by the Arduino is nothing but voltage signals. Regarding outputs, if you want to raise your hands, the brain sends electrical signals to your muscles, which is also neuron-to-neuron transfer, so outputs are also nothing but voltage signals. So remember this concept: whenever Arduino receives voltage inside it, it is called inputs, and whenever Arduino sends voltage outside from it, it is called outputs. So let's start with inputs. The human brain get inputs from the five sense organs. Likewise, Arduino can get inputs from various sensors which are available in the market. And all these sensors have a working voltage level of 5 volts. And Arduino also works in the same voltage level of 5 volts. So remember these important terms. The upper voltage level of our sensors and Arduino is 5 volts, which is also called VCC sometimes, or the logical one. Now the lower voltage level is 0 volts, which is also called ground, or the logical zero. Now the next question is, how does these sensors communicate through voltage? So let's take an example of a sound sensor, which works very similar to the human ear. So the sound sensor gets connected to the Arduino. Now the moment a sound is made, the sound sensor sends a voltage to the Arduino, and that brings us to the next question: what kind of voltage is being sent? So there are basically two kinds of voltage that is being sent from sensors: digital voltage and analog voltage. So let's start from digital voltage. To understand it better, let me ask you a simple question: can you hear any sound? So your answer can be either yes if you can hear any sound, or no if you can't hear any sound. So you have limited answers to that question. Likewise, a digital sound sensor will send digital voltage to Arduino, For example, if it senses a sound, it will send 5 volts to Arduino, and for no sound, it would send no voltage, or in other words, 0 volts. So that was about digital voltage. Now regarding analog voltage, let me ask you a different question. How much sound can you hear? We are talking about the quantity of sound, so you can't answer that by just saying yes or no. Now you will have more than two answers, like no sound, little sound, or medium level sound, for high level sound, or too much sound. Likewise, an analog sensor will send analog voltage to Arduino. For example, if it senses maximum level of sound, it will send its maximum voltage rating, that is 5 volts. For little lower level of sounds, probably 3.7 volts. And so on, until for no sound, it will send no voltage or 0 volt. So these numbers were just random examples, because the real output range can have any value between 0 and 5 volts. So that was all about the two types of voltages. In the next video, we'll learn about Arduino pin description. So that's it for this video, and thanks for watching.